Hello, I'm Bert Hensling, I'm your teacher in this part of the course. Now that we have made a list of the actors potentially involved, after making a pre-selection of those actors we think are most important to take along and learn more about, and after mapping their formal relations, we are now going to look for more in-depth information about the selected actors. Before we can start looking for them, we first have to define what we mean by objectives and interests. Well, objectives are the goals that an actor wants to achieve in a concrete situation. For instance, Greenpeace wants to prevent that an old oil rig is dumped in the deep sea. Interests, they are considered to be fundamental objectives. It is the reason why actors want to achieve a specific goal. It is the reason why they care. For instance, Greenpeace wants to prevent dumping old oil rigs because, they say, people are responsible for caring for the environment, and therefore we should protect marine ecosystems. Interests are deeply embedded in our personal values, and they are relatively stable over time. We can easily change our objectives, but we don't easily betray our interests. And thirdly, I want you to remember what we mean by perception. Perception is the way we look at the world, our worldview. It's largely based on selective information and our social background, and is influenced by peer pressure. Remember, in step two, we made a first provisional inventory of actors, and in this step, we will elaborate and do in-depth research after the interest, objectives and means. After mapping the formal relations, we have learned more about them, and at this stage, we need to be sure we have sufficient and reliable data. So, there is a need to do some additional research. Policy documents, annual reports, consulting experts in the field, maybe interviewing spokespersons in order to fill out the information card on each actor in more detail. Let us start with the Ministry of Infrastructure and Environment and its Directorate, Space and Water. Typically, the interest or fundamental objective of INM Space and Water is a safe, efficient and profitable use of the North Sea, while the concrete objective is creating space for offshore wind without impeding other users. The problem or cleft they perceive is that the talk is only about search areas, which has to do with the intensive use of the North Sea, especially in the near shore area. INM's preferred solution is to have its minister indicate more search areas. The same exercise we can do for other actors, like the ministry's other directorate Environment. Environment, although part of the same ministry, holds other interests. They want to reduce pollution, and they are concerned about CO2 emissions. Their objective is 20% renewables, preferably at sea. So you can see that their filled out fact sheet differs from that one of the Directorate of Space and Water. We can now do this for other actors, such as, for instance, the energy companies, and fill out their interests like producing energy and their objectives in the same way. And as a final step in making this inventory, you might make an overview table, where you can see in one glance all the actors, their interests, objectives, the problem as they perceive it, its causes, the preferred solutions, and their means, all in one big table.